welcome back to my channel. I have a new microphone, so if it's not working right, this whole video is going, honestly, it's probably not gonna go up. But hopefully you guys can hear me. I do got a little heater on down here because it's like 30 degrees in Atlanta, and I don't even really like the cold like that. So we're just gonna hop right into this video. If you are watching this video, you know by the title, we're gonna be talking about shrinkage. And if we are talking about shrinkage, you guys know that we're pretty much talking about wash and goes, right? We're not talking about twist outs, braid outs, nothing like that. We're talking about if you're getting a wash and go, you're trying to do a wash and go, and you don't want your hair to be like, you know, in the shrunken stage. This is not gonna include banding your hair. So, I mean, if you wanna band your hair, there are a ton of different videos on it. I actually have a video on it, I'll link it above, of how I use the banding method. But you can do your whole wash and go in 2 hours from when you start shampooing until your hair is dry, and your hair will be completely dry. So I'm super excited to talk about it. Okay, so we're just gonna hop right into it. The first thing that I do want to mention is to dry your hair under a hooded dryer if you're doing a wash and go. Now, this is very important because what the dryer actually does, and I've talked about this in another video, if you do air dry your hair is drying from the ends of your hair and it's going to the roots. Now, when you do that, whatever is moisturize, which would be your roots still because they're the last to dry, your hair is going to go towards the moisture. So that is why your hair shrinks up. When you are putting your hair under a hooded dryer, you are drying your hair from the roots down. So that way, when this dries, your hair is, it's just like, oh, the moisture is down here. So, oh, we're gonna go until we can't anymore. So like, I literally have the minimal amount of shrinkage when I sit under a hooded dryer. It's like amazing. I cannot, that is the best tip I can give anybody. If you don't take nothing from this video, boo, take the fact that you need to get you a hooded dryer. And the one that I use is back there. Like I said, I'll have the video linked so you can watch the video on that. So number two for avoiding a lot of shrinkage is to use water-based products. Waters are going to weigh your hair down. Make sure when you're in the shower, you are wetting your hair. This is why you put product on really wet hair. Like, it just weighs your hair down and causes for a long elongation, and it just helps a lot with your shrinkage. Sometimes you honestly have to part your hair, run that underwater, comb it, run it underwater while you're combing it, part the next part, like take smaller sections just to moisturize your hair, especially if your hair is low porosity. You're gonna wanna do that, okay? Just like literally start from the back like you're putting on the perm, but that water, like literally like getting that water into your hair is so important. Water-based products, so anything that starts off with water, anything that's heavy on the water side, definitely want to do that. I have so many of these, so yeah. So this is a really liquidy product, which is why it works so well on my hair. You definitely want a water-based product. It's going to help elongate. It just smooths out my hair so well. Find a gel or a product that is actually going to weigh your hair down just a tad bit to get more elongated curls. So the third tip that I want to talk about is to apply product to your roots. I honestly can't stress this one enough either. Like, if you have to put that leave-in or that moisturizer, that milk on the roots, you have to put water on your roots, you have to put the gel on your roots. When you do that and you smooth everything out, just take your time, your wash and goes will look so much better. Like, girl, just to give you like a visual, like I literally go start off by putting my gel on the ends, working that up, and then I smooth the gel on this side, lift that part over, put the gel on that side, and then I'm done. I have to like make sure that my roots are so smooth. If you're not doing that, get on it, boo. Get on it, I'm just saying. I mean, the third one kind of brings me to the fourth one, kind of ties in together. Work in smaller sections. Do not try to do bigger sections. That's not gonna help you. You're not getting every single strand of your hair coated with the product, which means you're gonna end up with frizz, which means you're gonna have shrinkage. You want to really work in smaller sections, smoothing things out, rubbing things in, getting those roots, and it's gonna make for a way better wash and go. Number five is when you are completely dry, your hair is completely dry, if you can just go in with that pick to your roots and just go ahead and stretch out some of these curls, because honestly, you don't need all of this to look super curly. This does not matter. What really matters is the ends looking curly. If your ends look curly, your wash and go is still gonna be popping. Number six is kind of on the same page as that, is to blow dry your roots. When I do sit under my hooded dryer, I only sit under there for about 30 minutes. After that, all of my hair here is already dry. So all I do is take my blow dryer and then I just kind of pin my hair up. I go in one little section and I'll take this section, blow dry those roots, and holding my hair taut like this, and I'll just blow dry those roots, take the next section, pull it, blow dry those roots. That's what I do, and it works every time like a charm, and you guys are going to thank me later. If you guys love these videos, where I'm very informative and letting you guys know some of my little tips, go ahead and give this a thumbs up, share it with your friends, share it with your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother. I don't care, just share my video. But yeah, I hope you guys like this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and your girl will see you in her next video. Bye. Mwah.